New dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
Whatever happened to Star? Breaking out in 2016, Star was about two sisters with a life full of tragedy who meet a fellow singer through Instagram. They decide to travel to Atlanta to try and land their big break as an R&B girl group. Star, the oldest fame-hungry sister, is played by Jude DeMores. Simone, Star's biracial sister, is played by Brittany O'Grady. And Alex, the music prodigy, is played by Ryan Destiny. The show started off highlighting Star's life in the foster system. Committed to her dreams as a singer, she tracks down her sister Simone and an IG singer by the name of Alexandra. The trio then make their way to Atlanta. Once there, the girls find support in the form of a mother figure, Carlotta, played by Queen Latifah, and a not-so-successful agent named Hayil, who takes a special interest in Star. As the young women chase their dream, they learn many lessons and face so many obstacles, teaching the audience that everything comes at a price, and some are just too high to pay. Even though real girl groups at the time were breaking up and couldn't really reach the same level of success as solo artists, Star attracted a growing audience. It was the music, the visuals, the A-list cast, the storylines, and so much more that drew in the viewers' attention. Star really made you feel like you were in the show, like you could be anything that you wanted to be. The abrupt cancellation of Star left viewers with anxiety and literally no closure. Get ready, because this is why I believe Star was canceled. It all started with a confrontation between Dame Dash and director of Star and Empire, Lee Daniels. Dame Dash confronted Lee Daniels in 2018 over a loan that was made 10 years prior.
So anyway, they told me to stay on the stage, okay, so I'm here. Can we turn the lights up a little bit out there, Jonathan? Any lights? That's it?
So after the incident, Dame Dash actually started doing interviews, and here's one. He sat down with Power 106 to talk about how Lee Daniels owes him money.
He hasn't paid you back.
Yeah, basically. You know, we had an agreement that if I gave him a certain amount of money, that he would give it back in a certain amount of time, and he just simply didn't do it. And, you know, over the years, he's, you know, sold me a lot of different dreams, the same one of me getting my money back, and you know, we've gone to court about it, and, you know, I haven't really had the pleasure of having a face-to-face with him in about a decade, so I ran into him, and I made sure that he couldn't say that I was doing anything violent, but I just really simply wanted an explanation.
Now, if you remember this time, social media was going crazy. Like, that video was viral, and a lot of people even mentioned the fact that Monique tried to warn us about Lee Daniels' character.
So, no, I was not blackballed. I was whiteballed. By some black dicks who had no balls. Thank you, Mr. Lee Daniels. Thank you, Ms. Oprah Winfrey. No, baby, I wasn't blackballed. I was fucked up by some niggas who had no balls. And see, I know they like to say, Monique, you talk too motherfucking much. It would kill me not to say the real shit. It would kill me not to say the real shit. You are not paying me equally. You are not treating me fairly. So y'all can suck my dick if I had one.
After the incident, Dame Dash then filed a $5 million lawsuit. Lee Daniels then goes on an interview, kind of contradicting himself, saying giving the money back is the right thing to do, then moments later stating that it was an investment.
I'm going to get it to him, because I think that that's the right thing to do. And it sadly took that wake-up call. Dory Diana reach out and touch somebody's head. It was an investment, but I looked him in the eyes, and I told him that you would get your investment back. He believed in me.
The lawsuit was eventually settled. Lee Daniels was ordered to pay Dame Dash almost $2 million in installments from November 2018 to January 2021. This settlement entitled Dame and Dash to any profits made from future films by Lee Daniels. Right after, Fox announced Star would be canceled. Even though Star was the little sister to the hit show Empire, It required a nice budget given the fact that it stars so many heavy hitting actors and actresses. Lee Daniels was mainly responsible for financially supporting Star. No bread, no show. So basically, Lee Daniels owed too much money to keep Empire and Star both running. So Lee Daniels chose Empire over Star because he wanted to give Empire a proper finale. That all went to shit when one of the actors on Empire made up false allegations and just fucked up the whole franchise, and it ended April 2020. Star fans had one more glimpse of hope on July 5th, 2019, when Lee Daniels took to Instagram to announce Star would not be picked up for a series, but it would be made into a movie.
Hey guys, I'm at the doctor's office, so I can't really talk loud, but I wanted to share some bad news and good news. The bad news is that Star is not getting picked up for series. Too long of a story to sort of cry about, but the good news is that we're doing a movie of the week to wrap things up for y'all. But what are you laughing at? Fish is laughing.
Yay!
And there's nothing funny. So that's the good news, is that, and we're gonna make something real special for you to scream about with all of our cast members. So even the dead ones. So,
buckle your seatbelts.
It's currently 2022 and we have yet to get a movie. Star's last episode was May 8th, 2019. I hope this provides audiences with some closure. And Star was really the shit. Like, that was my show. And I'm so sad that it's gone. But thank you for watching.